हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू यूजीसी ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर जितेंद्र सरोवा, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ ज्योग्राफी, डॉक्टर भीमराव अंबेडकर कॉलेज, यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ दिल्ली। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एलेबोरेट अपॉन मॉडर्न लाइफ एंड एटमॉस्फेरिक पोल्यूशन व्हिच कम्स अंडर द पेपर क्लाइमेटोलॉजी। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस डिस्कस व्हाट कुड बी द लर्निंग आउटकम ऑफ दिस मॉड्यूल। While going through this module, you will be able to understand the relationship between modern life and atmospheric pollution. You will be able to define atmospheric pollution. You will be able to identify the natural and anthropogenic causes of atmospheric pollution. You will be able to explain the primary and secondary pollutants. You will be able to describe the effects of air pollution. And finally, to suggest measures to check atmospheric pollution. Modern man is technologically and economically very advanced. The technological advancement in health sector and improvement in transportation and communication resulted into sudden decline of mortality rates. Comparatively, the fertility rates remained high and world population entered into population explosion stage of demographic transition. In 1650, world population was about 500 million. At present, world population is 7.4 billion. This population explosion has resulted into dramatic increase in the needs and wants of people. To fulfill these demands of growing numbers, exploitation of resources has taken place on unprecedented scale. The side effects of resource utilization is different types of pollution. The focus has remained on economic growth and increase in GDP, that is gross domestic production. The surplus production has been possible at the cost of environmental degradation and depletion. Technological advancement has taken place in all aspects of our life. Use of technology has resulted into mass scale production. To distribute this mass scale output, different modes of transportation have evolved over the period of time. The twin process of industrialization and urbanization is torch bearer of modern life. The chimneys and outcoming smoke and soot became a symbol of growth and prosperity. Cities became symbol of modern life and development. In 1800, urban share was just 2.4%. At present, 54% of the world population is urban, and future of world is also urban. Cities are the foci of exchange processes that are central to modern life. Due to clustering of population, industries and services, mega cities and modern metropolis have become the main source of atmospheric pollution. Industrial revolution, transport revolution, and urbanization processes were fueled or energized dominantly by fossil fuels. Like population explosion, the use of energy resources has also increased exponentially. Between 1820 to 1950, energy consumption increased 5 times. And it further increased about 5-fold by year 2000. Therefore, economic advancement and modern life depend on intensive utilization of energy resources. So far, especially fossil fuels, but all these advancements have resulted into atmospheric pollution, which is evident from local level to global level. Atmospheric pollution is commonly known as air pollution. The World Health Organization has defined air pollution as a situation in which the outdoor ambient atmosphere contains materials in concentration that are harmful to man and his surrounding environment. Air gets polluted through addition to it of gases, liquids, and solid particles detrimental to human health. air pollution is assuming serious proportions all over the world because atmospheric pollution doesn't follow political boundaries. Air is never perfectly pure. There are many natural and anthropogenic sources of air pollution. The natural sources of air pollution which have always existed are volcanic eruptions, salt particles from breaking waves from coastal areas, pollen and spores released from vegetation, smoke from wildfires, and wind-blown dust particles. Volcanic eruptions release sulfur, chlorine, and ash particles in atmosphere. Wind-blown dust is acquired usually from areas without vegetation or with little vegetation. Sandy deserts are the main source areas of dust particles. Salt particles are acquired from coastal areas. Radon, radioactive gas formed from the decay of radium rocks, can accumulate in buildings, especially in confined areas such as the basement. It is a health hazard and frequently causes lung cancer. Wildfires produce large-scale smoke and carbon monoxide. The major man-made sources of atmospheric pollution are burning of fossil fuels, which basically includes firewood, coal, natural gas, and petroleum products. Vehicular exhausts, smokes of domestic and industrial sources, particulate matters, forest fires, stubble burning, and activities such as mining, quarrying, and farming. Dust storms in USA during the 1930s represent an example of natural air pollution accentuated by human actions. They occurred due to expansion of agriculture on marginal lands and faulty methods of cultivation. The severe droughts made the plowed fields more vulnerable to prevailing strong winds. About two centuries ago, the most noticeable source of air pollution was filthy factories, which were representative of economic growth and industrial revolution. At present, most significant contribution comes from transport sector. Power plants and factories continue to make important contributions. Burning of fossil fuels for generating heat in industries, in thermal power plants, and in internal combustion engines leads to release of carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, oxides of nitrogen, sulfur, and particulate matter like soot and ash in the atmosphere. In transport sector, the number of vehicles has increased exponentially, especially in the last half century. Vehicles are a necessity as well as a status symbol in modern life. On one hand, they reduce the time and distance barriers, but on the other, vehicles exhaust contains all kinds of air pollutants like particulates, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxides, sulfur dioxide, volatile organic compounds known as VOCs, and lead, and indirectly produces ozone. Automobiles are the largest contributor to air pollution in cities like Delhi, where they account for over 71% of the total pollutants in the air. Along with Delhi, 9 more cities of India are in the list of 20 most polluted cities listed by WHO, that is World Health Organization. Traffic congestion due to increase in number of vehicles per unit area of roads, poor traffic management, lack of civic sense has intensified air pollution. It reduces speed, and low speed vehicles burn fuel inefficiently and pollutes more per trip. Adulteration of petrol and diesel with low priced fuels for economic gains is common practice in South Asia, especially India. The adulterants increase emissions of harmful pollutants, poor maintenance of vehicles and roads, and old automotive technologies also contribute in vehicular pollution. The key input of modern life is electricity to run industries, to sustain services, and to fulfill heating or cooling requirements of domestic and other purposes. Electricity is must. The overwhelming majority of electricity is still contributed by conventional power plants by burning fossil fuels. Thermal power plants produce a range of air pollutants like particulates, especially fly ash, sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides, and hydrocarbons. Industrial revolution resulted in phenomenal growth of industries initially in MDCs, that is more developed countries, and later on in some of the developing countries like China and India, of course. Industries provide employment opportunities and a great variety of value-added goods required in the modern society. Industries emit all sorts of pollutants. Industrial plants that produce metals such as aluminium, zinc, and steel, refine crude oil, manufacture cement, synthesize plastic, or make other chemicals are among those that produce harmful air pollution. Most of the industrial units emit pollutants continuously for long periods, producing time-specific and cumulative effects. Sometimes industrial plants accidentally release huge amount of atmospheric pollution. You all are aware about the leakage of poisonous gas MIC, that is methyl isocyanate, in the Bhopal gas tragedy of December 2nd, 3rd night 1984. This is a well-known accident related to air pollution globally. Therefore, it can be concluded that industries bring us economic prosperity, but their side effects include ill health and death also. Forest fires, natural or man-made, also contribute in air pollution. Occasionally, however, they contribute in air pollution over large areas. Forest fires in Indonesia, Australia, California, USA, and in Western Himalaya are common. Shifting cultivation or slash and burn agriculture also contributes in air pollution. Expansion of area under cultivation and faulty raw methods of tillage resulted into dust storms in USA in 1930s, as already mentioned. Fuel wood, cow dung, stubble, and agricultural waste burning also contribute in air pollution, especially in rural India. Cigarette, bidi, cigar, and hookah smoking are great pollutants of air in urban as well as rural areas. They significantly contribute in indoor pollution and are harmful for active as well as passive smokers. Let us try to understand the difference between primary and secondary air pollutants. The pollutants added to air directly from the identifiable sources that remain in the same chemical form as at the time of emission are called primary pollutants. These are emitted directly from the sources. They include particulate matter like ash, smoke, dust, and fumes. Inorganic gases such as sulfur dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen dioxide, ammonia, and hydrogen fluoride. Hydrocarbons and radioactive substances. Conversely, the pollutants that undergo chemical change in the atmosphere due to reactions among two or more pollutants are called secondary pollutants. These are formed in the atmosphere by chemical interactions among primary pollutants and normal atmospheric constituents. Pollutants such as sulfur trioxide, nitric acid, ozone, carbonic and sulfuric acids are major secondary pollutants. Let us now focus on effects of air pollution. Air pollution has various kinds of effects on human life, the most significant being the effect on human health. The other effects of atmospheric pollution are on vegetation, materials, and on weather and climatic conditions. Effects on human health is our primary concern. The primary and secondary air pollutants have serious harmful effects on human health. Respiratory diseases, lung problems, variety of cancers, and eye, nose, throat, and skin related problems are the most common adverse health effects of air pollution. Air pollution is a major environmental risk to human health. By reducing air pollution levels, countries can reduce the burden of diseases from stroke, heart disease, lung cancer, and both chronic and acute respiratory diseases, including asthma. According to the new WHO Air Quality Model 2016, 92% of the world population lives in places where air quality levels exceed WHO standards. In 2012, the estimated number of deaths associated with indoor and outdoor air pollution was about 6.5 million, which is about 11.6% of all global deaths. And it is almost an equal share from indoor and outdoor air pollution. About 90% of these deaths were reported from low and middle income countries, especially from WHO identified Southeast Asia and Western Pacific regions. Majority of these deaths, you can say 90%, are because of non-communicable diseases, notably cardiovascular diseases, stroke, chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, and lung cancer. These deaths reflect that the most vulnerable populations are women, children, and older adults. Effects on vegetation. The effects of air pollutants on plants depend upon their chemical nature, level of concentration, and exposure time. Sulfur dioxide, SPM, that is suspended particulate matter, and photochemical oxidants are the principal pollutants which deserve prime significance. As far as impact of vegetation and agriculture is concerned, air pollutants commonly damage the leaf structure. Excessive dust and smoke retards the growth of plants. Ozone reduces plant growth and crop productivity. The oxides of nitrogen and fluorides also suppress plant growth and damage leaf tissue. They can reduce the crop yields. Hydrocarbons such as ethane causes premature leaf fall and shedding of flower buds. Let us come to effects on materials. It is well known that air pollutants through physical and chemical processes damage materials. Sulfur dioxide, oxides of nitrogen, and particulate matter are the most destructive pollutants. The natural effects of corrosion and weathering are intensified by air pollutants. Acid rain is in fact a cocktail of sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Sulfur dioxide and nitrogen dioxide affect fabrics, leather, paint, and building stones. कार्बोनेट बेस्ड स्टोन्स पर्टिकुलरली सफर सीवियर इरोजन बिकॉज ऑफ एसिड रेन्स. दिस फिनोमिना इज नोन एज स्टोन लेप्रोसी. हिस्टोरिकल एंड हेरिटेज बिल्डिंग्स हैव बीन सीवियरली अफेक्टेड बाई पोल्यूटेंट्स सच एज ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ सल्फर एंड नाइट्रोजन. नाउ लेट अस कम टू इफेक्ट्स ऑफ एटमोस्फेरिक पोल्यूशन ऑन वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट. देर आर फोर मेजर इफेक्ट्स. द फर्स्ट वन इज स्मोक. द वर्ड स्मोक इज कम्बिनेशन ऑफ स्मोक एंड फोग. इट वॉज क्वाइंड टू डिस्क्राइब लंदन स्मोक इन 1952. द फोटोकेमिकल ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट्स इन टू सेकेंडरी पोल्यूटेंट्स रिजल्ट्स इन टू फॉर्मेशन ऑफ स्मोक. द प्राइमरी पोल्यूटेंट्स मेनली इंक्लूड नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड, कार्बन मोनोऑक्साइड एंड वेरियस अनबर्न्ड हाइड्रोकार्बन्स फ्रॉम अर्बन एंड इंडस्ट्रियल सोर्सेज. नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड एमिटेड इन एयर इज क्विकली ऑक्सीडाइज्ड टू नाइट्रोजन डाइऑक्साइड. सोलर अल्ट्रावायलेट रेडिएशन कॉजेज फोटोकेमिकल डीकम्पोजिशन ऑफ NO2 इंटू NO एंड O, मोनोएटोमिक ऑक्सीजन. मोनोएटोमिक ऑक्सीजन देन ज्वाइंस नेचुरल मोलिकुलर ऑक्सीजन दैट इज O2 टू फॉर्म O3 दैट इज ओजोन. द एडवर्स इफेक्ट्स ऑफ स्मोक आर नॉट लिमिटेड टू लोकल एनवायरमेंट बट टू फार अवे प्लेसेज एज वेल. स्मोक इज हार्मफुल टू ह्यूमन्स, वेजिटेशन एंड मटीरियल्स. द सेकेंड मेजर इम्पैक्ट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ एसिड प्रेसिपिटेशन. इट इज द रिजल्ट ऑफ लार्ज स्केल बर्निंग ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स इन व्हीकल्स, पावर प्लांट्स एंड इंडस्ट्रीज. एज ए रिजल्ट मिलियंस ऑफ टन्स ऑफ सल्फर एंड नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड्स आर रिलीज्ड इन टू द एटमोसफियर. सम ऑफ दीज पोल्यूटेंट्स थ्रू कॉम्प्लेक्स केमिकल रिएक्शंस गेट कन्वर्टेड इन टू एसिड्स एंड फॉल ऑन सरफेस एज रेन और स्नो. दिस इज नोन एज वेट डिपोजिशन. बाई कंट्रास्ट इन ड्राई एरियाज द एसिड प्रोड्यूसिंग केमिकल्स आर इनकॉर्पोरेटेड इन डस्ट एंड स्मोक एंड सेटल ऑन ग्राउंड एज ड्राई डिपोजिशन. दीज ड्राई डिपोजिट्स आर वॉश्ड बाई ओकेजनल रेन्स रिजल्टिंग इन टू एसिडिक सरफेस रन ऑफ. इन हाईली अर्बनाइज्ड एंड इंडस्ट्रियलाइज्ड एरियाज एसिड रेन्स हैव बिकम कॉमन. नॉर्दर्न यूरोप एंड ईस्टर्न नॉर्थ अमेरिका रिसीव वाइड स्प्रेड एसिड रेन. द मोस्ट वेल नोन डैमेजिंग इफेक्ट ऑफ एसिड रेन इज एलिमिनेशन ऑफ फिशेज फ्रॉम मैनी लेक्स एंड देयर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन टू डेड लेक्स. इन स्कैंडिनेविया एंड ईस्टर्न नॉर्थ अमेरिका इट इज वेल डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड. लेट अस कम टू थर्ड इम्पैक्ट दैट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ओजोन डिप्लीशन. इन मॉडर्न लाइफ CFCs दैट इज क्लोरोफ्लोरोकार्बन्स हैव प्लेड सिग्निफिकेंट रोल एज रेफ्रिजरेंट्स, सॉल्वेंट्स, प्रोपेलेंट्स एंड रिटार्डेंट्स. दीज कंपाउंड्स आर रेडिली लिक्विफाइड, रिलेटिवली इनर्ट, नॉन टॉक्सिक, नॉन कंबस्टिबल एंड वोलेटाइल. इन एडिशन लार्ज स्केल कंबशन ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स, इंक्रीज्ड यूज ऑफ नाइट्रोजन फर्टिलाइजर्स इन मॉडर्न एग्रीकल्चर एंड मॉडर्न सुपरसोनिक जेट प्लेन्स हैव इंक्रीज्ड नाइट्रोजन ऑक्साइड एंड अदर ऑक्साइड्स ऑफ नाइट्रोजन इन एयर. इन फोटोकेमिकल प्रोसेस नाइट्रिक ऑक्साइड एंड CFCs विद रिलीज ऑफ क्लोरीन एंड ब्रोमीन स्टार्ट ओजोन डिप्लीशन इन द स्ट्रेटोस्फियर. ड्यू टू अर्बनाइजेशन, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड ग्लोबलाइजेशन द अबंडेंस ऑफ ओजोन डिप्लीटिंग सब्सटेंसेस इंक्रीज्ड ड्रामेटिकली. इन 1985 ओजोन होल फॉर्मेशन वॉज रिपोर्टेड फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम बाय स्कॉलर फरमैन. मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल 1987 ऑन ODS दैट इज ओजोन डिप्लीटिंग सब्सटेंसेस इज ए लीगली बाइंडिंग इंटरनेशनल एफर्ट टू एड्रेस दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम. द फोर्थ इम्पैक्ट इज इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. मॉडर्न लाइफस्टाइल इज द मेन कॉज ऑफ ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. पॉपुलेशन एक्सप्लोजन, एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ रिसोर्सेज, बर्निंग ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स, अर्बनाइजेशन, इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन एंड कंज्यूमरिज्म हैव रिजल्टेड इनटू इंक्रीज्ड शेयर ऑफ GHGs, दैट इज ग्रीन हाउस गैसेज लाइक कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड, मीथेन, नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड, ट्रोपोस्फेरिक ओजोन एंड CFCs एंड देयर अल्टरनेट्स HCFCs. दीज हैव इन्हांस्ड ग्रीन हाउस इफेक्ट एंड रिजल्ट इज ग्लोबल वार्मिंग. मेजरमेंट्स ऑफ ट्रेस ग्रीन हाउस गैसेज इन द कंपोजिशन ऑफ एटमोसफेयर शो इंक्रीज्ड शेयर मेनली विद द बिगिनिंग ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल रेवोल्यूशन. द बर्निंग ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स इन हीटिंग, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड इंडस्ट्रियल एक्टिविटीज इज द प्राइमरी रीजन फॉर दिस ट्रेंड. द एक्सटेंशन ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड इंटेंसिव एग्रीकल्चर हैज ऑल्सो कंट्रीब्यूटेड सिग्निफिकेंटली. द प्राइमरी सोर्सेज ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड आर बर्निंग ऑफ फॉसिल फ्यूल्स, डिफोरेस्टेशन एंड फॉरेस्ट फायर्स. द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ मीथेन हैज मोर देन डबल्ड द प्री इंडस्ट्रियल लेवल एंड इज स्टिल इंक्रीजिंग. इट इज ड्यू टू इंक्रीज इन एरिया अंडर पैडी कल्टिवेशन एंड इंक्रीज इन कैटल पॉपुलेशन. मीथेन इज प्रोड्यूस्ड बाई एनएरोबिक बैक्टीरिया इन वेट प्लेसेस सच एज स्वैम्प्स, बोग्स, वेटलैंड्स, फ्लडेड पैडी फील्ड्स एंड द गट्स ऑफ ग्रेजिंग एनिमल्स लाइक शीप एंड कैटल. मीथेन इज ऑल्सो रिलीज्ड इन कोल माइंस एंड इन ड्रिलिंग ऑफ क्रूड ऑयल एंड नेचुरल गैस. नाइट्रस ऑक्साइड ओरिजिनेट्स प्राइमरी फ्रॉम माइक्रोबायल एक्टिविटी इन सॉयल्स एंड इन ओशंस. अदर एंथ्रोपोजेनिक सोर्सेज आर नाइट्रोजन फर्टिलाइजर्स, फ्यूल एंड बायोमास बर्निंग. CFCs वर फर्स्ट प्रोड्यूस्ड इन 1930s फॉर देयर मल्टीपल यूजेस. एज ए रिजल्ट ऑफ द मॉन्ट्रियल प्रोटोकॉल एग्रीमेंट्स टू करटेल प्रोडक्शन ऑफ CFCs एंड टू यूज सब्स्टिट्यूट्स दे हैव स्टेबलाइज्ड. देयर सब्स्टिट्यूट्स HCFCs दैट इज हाइड्रोक्लोरोफ्लोरोकार्बन्स हैव ए लार्ज ग्रीन हाउस पोटेंशियल. फॉर सस्टेनेबल डिवेलपमेंट चेकिंग एयर पोल्यूशन इज ए प्रायोरिटी और शुड बी ए प्रायोरिटी. एयर पोल्यूशन कैन बी प्रिवेंटेड एंड कंट्रोल्ड थ्रू लीगल एंड टेक्नोलॉजिकल इंटरवेंशंस विद पीपल पार्टिसिपेशन. द लीगल अप्रोच फोकसेस ऑन द एस्टेब्लिशमेंट ऑफ एयर क्वालिटी स्टैंडर्ड्स. एंटी एयर पोल्यूशन लॉज हैव बीन इंट्रोड्यूस्ड वर्ल्ड वाइड ड्यूरिंग द सेकेंड हाफ ऑफ द 20th सेंचुरी. फॉर इंस्टेंस इंडिया इनेक्टेड द एयर Prevention and Control of Pollution Act in 1981, followed by another important enactment, that of Environment Protection Act 1986. Many of the once polluted cities and industrial regions now have relatively clean air due to these legislative measures. These measures are related to emission norms and standards, fuel and lubricant quality specifications, alternate fuels, and land use planning. The best strategy is to prevent pollution of air. The magnitude of air pollution can be controlled and reduced by following preventive measures such as use of less energy, more efficient utilization of energy, shift on non-conventional environment friendly sources of energy, proper land use planning to restrict and control location of industries, installation of industries subject to environmental safeguards, creation of green belts around urban and industrial areas, maintenance of roads and management of traffic, use of smarter technologies in vehicles, households, industries, and power plants, ensures pollution control and prevention. Use of taller chimneys, removal of pollutants from fuel like lead-free gasoline, use of catalytic converters, filters, scrubbers, settling chambers, and electric precipitators, proper treatment of sewage and other wastes before disposal. Use of chemical processes like absorption, adsorption, and condensation to remove pollutants at source. The use of precipitators can reduce the problem caused by thermal power plants. Use of environment-friendly fuels like CNG and LPG can help checking vehicular pollution. Better maintenance of machines and proper lubrication can reduce wear and tear of machines and thus reduce metallic particles in air. In addition to legislative and technological measures, public awareness and participation play a significant role in prevention and control of air pollution. As atmospheric pollution doesn't follow political boundaries, international cooperation is required. One successful and motivating example is ratification of Montreal Protocol on ozone depleting substances by all 197 UN member states. The basic requirement to tackle air pollution is spatio-temporal database. In India, in 1984, Central Pollution Control Board started National Ambient Air Quality Monitoring Program, which was subsequently renamed as National Air Monitoring Program or NAMP. Among other things, the program determines the status and trends of ambient air quality to ascertain whether the prescribed ambient air quality standards are violated. The program also focuses on assessment of health hazard and damage to materials due to pollution. Central Pollution Control Board, that is CPCB, has launched the National Air Quality Index, AQI, in the year 2015. The motive is to provide information to public on the status of ambient air quality of selected cities regarding 8 pollutants. These 8 pollutants include sulfur dioxide, nitrogen dioxide, lead, ozone, PM10, that is particulate matter 10 micron, PM2.5, carbon monoxide, and ammonia. Let us come to the summary and conclusions of this module. Atmospheric pollution has a close association with modern way of living. The ever-increasing population, affluence, and technology have intensified atmospheric pollution. Population explosion has resulted into dramatic increase in needs and wants of people. To fulfill these growing needs and wants, exploitation of resources has taken place on unprecedented scale. Burning of fossil fuels is the most important air pollutant source. The twin process of urbanization and industrialization intensified atmospheric pollution. Expansion of agriculture and intensive agriculture in the form of green revolution and livestock rearing, deforestation, and forest fires have also contributed significantly in air pollution. Primary pollutants and transformations as secondary pollutants have various kinds of adverse effects on human health, vegetation, materials, and weather and climatic conditions. In 2012, the estimated number of deaths associated with indoor and outdoor air pollution was 6.5 million as per WHO report. Acid rain, smoke, ozone depletion and global warming are all result of air pollution caused by modern way of living. Air pollution can be prevented and controlled through legal and technological interventions, but with people participation. Policies and investments promoting cleaner, sustainable transport, energy efficient housing, power generation and manufacturing, and better management of waste would reduce key sources of air pollution. Thank you. Thank you very much.